Okay, everybody, today I got out of here a little late. Wind's blowing like crazy, like it's been doing. And what I'm doing today is I'm gonna use the brand new VersaMax Pro Max cork. The guys at VersaMax came out with this stainless steel wire, got the ball bearings in here, make really loud noise. But the true thing is, as always, they have their patented wrap fast and cast little catch on the bottom of these things that's just phenomenal. You know, one of the biggest problems, and you've heard me say it, with these style corks is that, you know, when you tie these on, you're gonna tie this going the top of it back to your rod. But then underneath, you tie a leader, and then whatever you're gonna put, jig head, if you're gonna put a kale hook or whatever. But on all of the corks, you can't adjust the depth. The only way to adjust the depth is to cut the line, then go ahead and retie a longer leader or a shorter leader. And what that does, it makes very lazy fishermen, because guess what? You don't cut the line and you don't change your depth. And as you know, inshore fishing, that is really, really important, because you may fish a point where you need to be a little shallow, and then you move out into some reefs or you're fishing at a rig and you need to be deeper. And you need to change that depth to be the most productive that you can be. Now, a lot of people will say, oh, I'll change my line. They don't do it. I see it with charters all the time. They bring their own corks out. They don't change the leader depth, even though I'm changing it. They don't want to change it. They just want to leave it alone. So this is the new Pro Max. It's really heavy, really loud. I'm going to show you how to rig it up. Now, this would go back to your rod. You just tie it up to your fishing pole. But on these, the cool thing about these is that this little deal here, you can wrap it and change your depth. So I'm gonna show you, I got 30 pound monofilament. There's a hole that's drilled in this thing. You're gonna put your 30 pound monofilament, make an overhand knot. I usually do two of them just to give me a little security on that, because you're never gonna get to that depth, but I like to have it where it's got a little bit of a little bit bigger knot. Now that tag end is on there. What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna cut that knot, that tag end right at the knot. Now, that is gonna secure my leader to this catch. Now what you're gonna do is, I'm gonna want 6 feet of line, let's say, that I'm gonna put on there where I can do it. All you're gonna do is you're gonna wind it up on this spool a few times to give you your depth. Every time you go around is about an inch. Once you do that, there's a slit in here. You're gonna slide it in the slit, and then you're gonna go in the catch, and you're gonna make it click. You'll hear it click. One, two, and three. Now, I've got that. I can put it at whatever depth I want. Now I'm at my depth. Let's just say I wanna get a little deeper. All I do, come out, click it out three times. One, two, three, like I initially did. Come out of the slit. Now I can go another foot, foot and a half deeper without having to cut my line. And if I wanna go shorter, I just spool it up and go around. And you could do it with braid, you could do it with any kind of line. I like to use monofilament just because it gives me a little stretch on my stuff. But I'm gonna go ahead, I got my spool filled up. Now I'm gonna make my clicks, one, two, three. I'm gonna cut my line at about, 2 feet. So that gives me now about 6 feet of line that I can use. And I just tie up whatever I'm gonna put on here. So I'm gonna put a jig head today. I'm gonna fish some stuff with live bait, and we're gonna see how we do. I haven't used this cork yet. This is the first time I've used it, and I'm gonna see how it does. So I'm just tying me a regular cinch knot on here for my jig head, and we're gonna see what happens. I'm gonna tie it on there, and we'll go fishing, or like I like to say, we're gonna go catching. All right. Let's see what happens. All right, there he is. Whoa, hit me right there. Okay, so this VersaMax cork, the Pro Max series. Oh, nice speckled trout right here. Let's see. Oh, he got off right there at the boat. But the thing is that it makes a lot of noise. So, I mean, this is my first time using it. One of the things that I notice is it makes, I can hear that from way over there. I mean, it's really, really loud. The second thing is this big old stainless steel ball right here. That's a half ounce or 3/8. I can't really tell, but it's one or the other, because it's really heavy. I can cast this thing forever, especially with the wind blowing. So It's heavy, makes a lot of noise, and if you notice, you can see the little bit of like little curlicues in my line. I was about this deep and I wasn't deep enough. I lowered it down and gave myself about another foot, maybe a little more than foot, like 14 inches, because what I'm doing is, this is a pipeline canal. You can even see like way up there, there's a dam that goes across it. The water's coming and pouring out of here, and I'm fishing this point up here and coming along. Well, the reason why this is important to know about a cork like this is to be able to change that depth over where the land is. That used to come all the way out here. There's a hump right there. The fish are not there. They're on the deeper end of the drop-off. Well, if I'm only at a foot and a half, I won't be able to catch fish because the flat doesn't produce. You need to be on that drop-off, and you need to be down about, I mean, I'm at about, I don't know, 4.5 feet. So you need to definitely understand that having this catch here that allows you to make fast adjustments on your depth is key to catching fish. I mean, that's what it is. Now, this one is a stainless steel wire, and then they have a titanium wire also that you can get. This is the one they sent me, so I got the stainless steel, and this sucker is thick. I mean, you're not bending that thing, that's for sure. And it'll last forever because it's stainless steel. All right, I'm using just the jig head, kind of giving you what's going on. Putting live shrimp, putting them on through the tail. I want to do that. Number one, I'm doing it through the tail because you know I love to do that with a jig head. Number two, the reason why is that I'm fishing wind and the tide going against each other. I'm having to pop it really hard, and that shrimp will rip off if I just put it through the horn or through the back. So let's cast out. I'm gonna get right on that drop off again. I'm right there on the drop. You just think about that bank extending out, and that's where I'm fishing. So that was a really nice trout that I just had on. Lost them at the boat, but we'll see if we got any more fish right here. This is a great spot for this scenario, fishing deeper ledges where these fish hold. Oh, goodness gracious, look at that rod bend. Woo, I got a big fish on right here, y'all. Now, it was right on that ledge, so I could tell that because my cork was laying sideways, and as soon as that jig head fell off into the deeper water, the cork stood up. I popped it a couple of times with that loud clack, and guess what? Oh, this is a big old fish. I don't know what it is, but he's really big. You see the head shake? Wow. Oh. Now, as one of my good clients and good friends, Stan Fleenor from Ocean Springs, Mississippi, he always says, the wind is your friend. And it is windy today, and it's definitely my friend because it's helped me catch these big fish. Let's see what it is. Oh my goodness. Now this is a test to this cork right here. Wow, it's a big old black drum. Shows you how strong this cork is. I mean, this is a big fish, and I really pulled them in hard. I got my drag set really tight. Oh, goodness gracious. Oh, man. And then you can see that cork, high visibility. So not only are you able to see it when you're popping it, but also, you know, when you're fishing, one of the things I notice a lot during my charters is that my customers can't tell where each other's corks are. And when, especially when they're reeling in a fish and then they kind of get all tangled up and everything, high visibility cork like this, this green color, really shows up well, and it allows everybody to see where that line is to where they can keep out of the way of everybody. Let me tell y'all something. This fish, he's big. He's not gigantic, but he's big. But he is fighting like crazy. He's got this rod bent over. You can hear the line singing in the wind from it being so tight. Oh, I'm trying to force him. Now, one of the things with a big fish, y'all, I want to tell y'all while I'm doing this, a lot of people, when they have a fish on, they just reel like this. They sit there and reel. When you're reeling like that against a big fish, nothing's happening. The drag is just giving out because the pressure of the fish is way more than what the rod can handle or the reel. Okay, wait, hold on. He's going back there. He wants to get in them power poles. They love those power poles. But I'm going to show you right now. So when you're bringing in a fish like that, you keep your rod high. You see the bend in that rod? You want to keep that. And then let the fish do his thing. Like right now, he's fighting. You just hold him against him, let him kind of wear himself out. once he kind of turns towards you and gives up, or you get way up, you keep the rod bent and reel down the rod, meaning reel that tip down, but don't drop your tip. A lot of people do this. They drop down and reel. You'll lose the fish that way. What you want to do is you want to keep the rod bent and reel down, and then that takes up the line. Then you can pull back up. And then you reel, keeping the rod tip bent, keeping that tension, and you'll get that fish. Let me tell y'all something. This fish wore me out. That's a big old drum. Look at this thing. On that VersaMax. Oh, Pro Series. Oh, let's see. Come here, big boy. Man, look at that fish, y'all. Oh, now these drum like this, uh-oh, he's almost about to come off the hook. These fish like this, these big drum, they're not good to eat. They're awesome to catch. A fun fish to have fun with, but they usually get worms in them because once they get over about, I don't know, 18, well, I'd say 20, 20 to 22 inches, they start feeding on oysters more. And because they feed on the oysters, that means that they get a parasite in them, which is a little worm, and them worms get all up inside of the meat. You clean them and you end up throwing all the meat away because it's got worms in it. You're not gonna eat it. Some people say extra protein, I don't know. But this big old fish, what you do with them is you take a picture, and then what you do is you throw them back and enjoy it. I'm gonna get a picture of it this one right now. All right, I got my picture. I'm gonna release it back in. And the thing is with these drum is just make sure that you kind of let them get their, you know, breathing back and get used to being in the water a little bit after that really hard fight. Cause I know I'm tired and I'm sure it's tired too. All right, this might take a little bit. We'll come back catching more fish. Oh, that cork just went down. Let's see what we got here. Oh, it seems like something pretty big. I don't know what it is. Now this current is rolling out of this pipeline right here into this bay. And the water's probably about, I don't know, it's about 7-8 foot deep right there. Oh, I don't know what this is, y'all. Fighting like an alligator. But I know it's not. Alligators like to just kind of barely swim. That's what this thing's doing. Oh, no, it's another one of those big old drum. He didn't even know he was hooked. Man, that is so awesome. I love catching drum like this. They're so fun. They fight so hard. Oh, wow. And this is a true testament to this cork, y'all. This is a big fish catching them on here. And I mean, I got my drag set really. Oh. All that headway I made, I just lost it all. He doesn't want to quit either. Look at him. Oh my golly. Why did he do that to me? Oh, this is going to be. Oh, goodness gracious. I'm not gonna lie to y'all. Whew! To wear out your arm for sure. Oh, goodness gracious. Oh. Now, as you see, I'm reeling up that line. Oh, he's coming right at me now. He's swimming right at me. Keep on coming, buddy. But like, you can see that cork. Look, coming across the water, it's very high visibility. I was able to drop my depth. On the day of testing this cork, I'm gonna say it's an A plus. Oh goodness, and the fish love it. Oh, because that sound, that clicking sound, makes them think that it's the sound of like shrimp or croakers. If you're a diver, you know that out in the wild, when you're underwater, it's nothing but clicking sounds everywhere. And every species of fish and shrimp and crabs, they all have their own little clicking sound, mostly bait fish. The bigger the fish get, like this drum, they make really big croaking sounds. Oh, goodness gracious. Woo! I'm not gonna lie to y'all, that arm's gonna be tired today. He won't quit. This is crazy. Oh, geez, on peace. Man, and I'm gonna tell y'all, this isn't a small action reel or rod here. I got a medium heavy rod. I got braid on here. That fin's braid. I gotta go all the way to the back of the boat, y'all. He's going back here. They love to get by these power poles for some reason. Okay. Ugh. He just wants to do whatever he wants to do. I gotta wear this fish down. There's nothing I can really do about that. I'm gonna bring him all the way around. He's just going. I can't even do anything, y'all. He's so, and he's big, don't get me wrong, but I catch really big drum. This thing here, this is like the Rocky Balboa of drum. Oh, he just never gives up. Oh, goodness gracious. It's a lot of weight there, y'all, a lot of weight. Look at him. Oh, it is so pretty. These fish are gorgeous. You don't like that. Look how big that fish. He's good, but we catch him a lot bigger that don't fight anywhere near as much as this one. All right. Come here, buddy. Oh, well, everybody, this Versamax Cork has done it. I've changed depth a couple of times. It works perfect. You learn how to use this. I promise you, you'll catch a lot of fish. It helps you catch fish because you can change that depth every time you go to a different spot. Look at this. What's up, buddy? Oh, wow. That is so awesome. And I'm gonna show y'all before we leave. Number one, make sure you subscribe to my channel. Number two, we'll put a link for these at the bottom. And number three, come look at this drum real quick. If you look way down in his throat down there, do you see all those little bumps? That's not bumps, y'all. You know what that is? Those are big crushing teeth down there that they have in their throat. And what they do is that they crush oysters and crabs with those. And it is this thing here, they're like cattle when they get on a spot where there's oysters. All right, y'all, this is awesome. Awesome fish. I'm out. I gotta revive him up a little bit because he fought really hard. I'll see y'all next time on the water.